It's time now for the next After the Fact mystery. Tonight, recipe for murder.
I knew we should have turned tail and run. You know, first the winch handle goes overboard, and now we get stuck here. We could dog paddle to Tobermory faster than this.
Keep your voice down. He'll hear us.
No, he's bottled up in his cabin, probably wishing he'd never laid eyes on this boat. Some vacation.
He's taking it pretty hard. I didn't want to ask too many questions.
Don't ask any. The fewer questions, the sooner we can get out of here. And as soon as we saw that distress flag, I knew that we should have swung right around and skedaddled.
So much for the camaraderie of the high seas. Well, if our boat starts to sink, at least I know who's going to be the first one in the lifeboat.
Oh, now come on, Dana. It's different with you and me. Of course I'd save you. You owe me money.
I'm touched. But how could we know we'd get pulled into a missing person case? I thought this guy was just lost, or out of water, or something.
He's out of luck, that's what he's out of. Imagine going out on a boat like this and not even knowing a jib from a giblet.
Shh, come on. Let's go into the galley.
Phew. What a mess. Must have been quite a squall. It's a wonder he got back.
Ugh, must have been terrible. Losing his partner overboard like that. What could he do? No way he could turn this boat around and pick the guy up. He must have been terrified.
Not as terrified as the guy in the water, I'll bet.
I tell you, from now on, I'm going to sleep in my PFD.
Ooh, that would make for one very personal flotation device. Actually, I believe the late partner of Mr. Crevasse was exceedingly careless for a supposedly seasoned sailor. I mean, no PFD, no safety harness. Not so much as a whistle or a flashlight around his neck.
He was caught off guard. You know how quickly this light can whip up. He stands up in a wind shift, the boom tags him, and no whistle in the world is going to do much good.
Is that what Crevasse said? That the boom nailed him?
Well, that's what he told me when you were tying us off. Think they'll ever find him?
Sometime. Somewhere, probably. Without flotation, he could go under and stay under for days. And then, during somebody's little outing, surprise, guess who popped over for potato salad?
You're awful. Look at this. The storm even dumped the spices out of their racks.
Don't touch anything.
What's the matter?
It's a work of art. Not long ago, you were ready to pay big money for that kind of masterpiece.
Will you grow up? I didn't buy that painting.
Look, Dana, dear, I don't think there's much more that we can do for the remorseful Mr. Crevasse. I mean, his radio's out. He can use ours to call the Coast Guard, but I'm not sure that they can do much either. Man overboard. Clean and simple. It happens all the time. Now what are you doing? You going to make us an omelet?
Look in this cupboard at this stack of pots and pans, Mark. Notice anything?
Greasy buildup?
Don't try my patience. Look again. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I am. If you're thinking, let's get out of here just as fast as we can.
Yeah, and let the Coast Guard pick up the deadly Mr. Crevasse.
Well, here they come. Mr. Crevasse is a pretty fair sailor after all. But I don't think he's going to outrun that cutter.
Too bad his partner wasn't a little faster. He might still be alive.
Hard to say. Crevasse must have had just about everything figured out. knock his partner on the head, dump him in the drink, and blame the little liquidation on the boom and a squall that he never sailed into.
He'd probably worked out every little detail of how he was going to liquidate the business, too.
Well, you can count on that. But I don't think you're going to be finding him in the Fortune 500 anytime soon.
No. More likely behind bars. Dumping the spices out of their racks would have been pretty convincing. If he hadn't forgotten to have his squall knock over the pots and pans hidden away in the cupboards.
Too bad he didn't have a winch handle in there.
Be sure to listen for the next After the Fact mystery.